In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the determination of the pKa of methyl red. I think I have everything here in the picture that you need. Here is the actual sample of methyl red. Methyl red looks like it was manufactured sometime in the early 70s, but it's still good. And it is a solid, a near black solid. This next beaker is the 1% solution of methyl red, and you can see that even though it's only out of 1% concentration, it's still tremendously highly colored. And then here is the buffer that I'm going to make the stock solution in. I don't need precision with this because you know that the concentration of dye does not show up anywhere in the actual equation for pKa that we are using today. However, just to make it reproducible so I can have several runs of this, I'm using a micro pipette. And there is our diluted dye. It's going to be the solution that we used for spectrophotometry. I'm going to fill each of these cuvettes. So one of these is at pH 5. Well, all of these are at pH 5. I'm going to react one with sodium hydroxide, so one will be in the base form. Adding one drop of sodium hydroxide. Kind of sinking down to the bottom there. If things don't mix, they can't react. Now we have the yellow or pure base form. This is highly concentrated hydrochloric acid. Add one drop of that. And now we have the acid form or the red form. The middle is orange because it's got yellow compound and red compound in it. Okay, let's have a look at the spectrophotometer now. It is a thermoscientific Genesys 30. These are commonly used in research labs, in medical labs, and of course in college labs also. Some controls and a nice display. And then this part is the sample compartment. The beam of light travels across this way, and the cuvette has a face on its marked, and we'll put the front face of the cuvette in the line of the sample beam. Before I can run a spectrum of any of these things, I have to zero the instrument. So I have a cuvette with buffer. Close the lid because I want to get a spectrum of the buffer, not of the room light. And then I want to get just the visible region. This instrument will go into the ultraviolet and into the infrared a little bit. So I'm going to change the lower limit to 400 and the upper limit to 750. That's the visible region. And then, as the instructions say, press 00. It will scan through the spectrum of water and then subtract that away from the other spectra that you take. It holds this spectrum in memory, and one background like this can be good for many spectra. It's in memory, it doesn't display it, so I'm going to take the water sample out and put the base sample in. And then according to the directions, I push the play symbol. And again, it's scanning, starting at 700, but this time we actually see the spectrum. It's auto Y scaling, which is why it's kind of going crazy there. Okay, and there's the spectrum of the base form. I don't want to lose this. USB drive. All right, and it's saved. Base sample out. Acid sample in, the red, the pink sample. And scan. And once again, save. And that is done. Finally, the third sample is going to be the pH 5 sample, the orange sample, the in-between sample. Okay, and I will have these three files available for you in order to complete the calculations of the pKa.